Hi, Kiran.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, so finally you come to the end of the first online corporate training conducted by BM English Speaking. And the entire course was conducted by you itself, right? So
Yes, sir.
good. So I think a lot of our trainers at BM would like to know about this experience of yours. So can you tell us from the start, from the first time you got to know about it, and how did it go?
Yes, sir. So I would say it all started with a call from Ritu, and it was afternoon time, and I was just about to take a nap, and then she calls me and she completely woke me up. She's like, there is one online TNA to be conducted. I agreed, but then immediately I get a call from Pierce sir that it's to be done on Zoom. Now, frankly speaking, I had never heard of Zoom. But then sir said, are you keen to learn? And I said yes, but then I didn't know what I was getting into. Because for the ones who don't know, I have a phobia, or I had a phobia of preparing PPTs or anything to do with technology. So in the classroom, I was fine conducting sessions, one-to-one, personal. But online, the word online itself gave me shivers. So what I did was, now first of all, the challenge, I had two challenges here. How to make the course effective online, because we were doing it for the first time. And secondly, I had a personal challenge because I hardly used to spend my time on the laptop. So what I did was, without wasting a single day, I went to meet sir at Kandivali Center and I told him, sir, now please, I am your student and teach me. And we all know sir's excellence with PowerPoint presentations. So I think all these years I really wasted by not taking the initiative. So this time sir taught me, I would say he taught me so quickly and so easily. Initially I took his help, a lot of help. I had to go twice. The second time also I had to go to meet sir, discuss what would be the course module, how we would conduct the sessions, the PowerPoints, how to make it effective. The grammar sessions had to be taught. And that's when the journey started, my personal journey also, wherein I learned to make PPTs from sir. Earlier, I was dependent. After that, I started doing on my own. So personal achievement also, yes, great. I'm really thankful to sir for that. Then, now because this course was conducted online and I had no control over the learners, as in to see whether they were paying attention. Of course, paying attention we could manage, but then whether they were copying the answers or not, or there are a lot of other hurdles that we face when we are doing it online. So it was important to take their tests. Now, how to do that online? So here, Ganesh came into the picture, and I forwarded the files to him of tests. I prepared tests, regular tests during the course, and Ganesh did a wonderful job by preparing tests. In fact, we also had a speech competition recently. And yes, the other challenges that I faced during this training, sometimes there were network issues, sometimes there would be a power cut there, or once or twice it happened at my home also. And yes, the best part was I was doing all this from home. So when there was a power cut, then I started using hotspot. So there are various options also available. And whenever there was any problem I had, there were some breakdowns also. Like once I prepared a PPT and sir gave me the permission that, okay, you share it. But then I didn't see it so effective. Then that's where there was a learning for me. Then sir brainstormed with me again, and after that there was no looking back. I started working from the perspective of the learners, how that would help them. And after that I started preparing PPTs accordingly, and most of the things I would say were similar. Like what I would do here in the class, I did it same online also. So yes, and used all the features of Zoom. Zoom is a very friendly software for all us trainers, and I think everybody, all of us trainers, should give it a try. And I must say that if I can do it, you can do it too.
Yeah, Kiran. So, so let's take it part by part. Let's say you have to take a grammar training online. Yes. Now, to conduct a grammar training offline is very different than doing it online, because you don't know, learners are looking at the books, paying attention. So what was the difference and how did you manage it? And that also, and the same thing we would, I think we all trainers would like to know about all.
So there was some network issue. And this is exactly what used to happen in the class. I missed some part of what you were saying.
Okay. I'll just repeat my question.
Yes.
Okay. So trainers would like to know, there are various modules that you conducted, let's say grammar, right, speaking, group discussion, then various other activities that you conducted, which we do offline in a training center.
Correct.
How did you conduct it? Challenges you faced in, and how effective it was. So yes, if you could tell exactly.
Sir, it was, honestly speaking, it was done exactly the same way, or in a way I would say better, because in the classroom we might move around, but here all my focus was on the learners. I could see them, I could understand, I could figure out when they were moving, when they were not paying attention. All that was possible because I had this gallery view here in front of me and I was not moving. They were not moving from their seats. So in fact, I took it as an advantage. And as far as grammar sessions are concerned, we have PPTs prepared already. There were PPTs prepared on the grammar sessions. So the Zoom has this feature where we can share the file. So the learners were able to see, I was able to see, and I would also keep talking in between so that it would not become dull. So I would keep explaining. And after that, as we do in the classroom, similarly, I would ask them to do their homework, and one by one, each one of them in the next session would share their homework. So generally, I would say there was not much of a difference. Like initially, I felt it would be really tough. But then once when I started doing it, I realized it was in fact more fun doing it, and it was effective as well, because I would ask each and every learner.
Okay, so that is about.
Yes,
sir. Go ahead.
Yeah, so I would ask each and every learner to tell the answers, how we do it in the class. So each learner had to share the answers one by one, and I would make corrections if they were wrong. So they would never feel that it was all very mechanical. I mean, they would get personal attention. Each one got personal attention. And yeah.
This is about a grammar module. Then how did you conduct speaking activities online? And what is the difference between doing it offline and online?
The only difference, and next time I might try that also, the only difference is here the learners were speaking while they were seated, and in the class they do it standing. Otherwise, you can see the facial expressions of the learners. You can listen to them clearly. You can you give them a topic, and then in between or at the end, you give them feedback. It is just the same. And as I told you, the software, there were 15 learners in one batch. So when one would speak, the others would listen. Just like a classroom.
Sir, did you conduct any group discussion kind of activity?
Yes, of course. I did everything that we do in the class. I played a probing game with them. I did a memory game with them.
Okay, great.
Yes, all the activities, the way we do it in the class.
Which other activities did you conduct? A group discussion as well?
Role play also.
Role play.
I did role play. Like I explained to them about role plays, and then two learners spoke enacting the role. The role that I gave them to do, they did that exactly the same. And in fact, today, which was the last day of one training of basic batch, and on the last day of advanced batch also, I conducted soft skills in detail where there was teamwork. So I also made them do an activity where they got up from their seats and they did the activity, treasure hunt. And so they did that activity in the class. I could see. So I did not ever feel that I was so apart from those people.
Okay, so let's say this was, I think, a 30-hour training. How many hours?
Yes, 35 hours each.
35 hours.
So that comes to
70. So what are the kind of results that you have produced, and how do you compare your results with offline training?
Sir, here I will be a little biased and I'll say the results were better, or they were the same. There was no difference at all in online, because regular tests were conducted, and I maintained Excel sheets of their attendance, of their results, test reports. Four tests in all were conducted. So if I compare how the level was on the first day for the TNA, sir, you were also with me. So they were able to speak. They were
absolutely. I was also there in the last speech competition. They all were speaking really very well.
Exactly, sir. And they were so happy. In fact, I keep getting messages even now on my personal window. Also, I got some messages. So they were thanking me for the kind of training that they got and the improvement, and the winners also. They were really feeling proud. But in between, yes, as it happens in all kinds of trainings, in between, learners do tend to get lax. So here, from time to time, that polite hammering had to be done. So that was done just the way we do it in classroom training. So I would say I could not find much of a difference in online and offline. Like, if you are totally involved into it, then you can produce the same results online also.
Yeah, and also one more challenge that we were facing is that 60%, the course objective of 60% of people was about writing. They wanted to be more effective in writing on Skype chats, emails, reports and all. So how did you tackle that, and how much was the improvement?
Sir, the biggest challenge here was how to improve their writing. So I use the chat many times here, because we have this feature of chat on Zoom. So many a times while speaking with them, I would write something in the chat box and make them write and then make the corrections. So that would be about singular sentences, like one or two sentences like this from everybody. Then at times I used WhatsApp also. We had this group, so whatever assignments they would do, like written work, because we only have a grammar book which they had, which they could do and read the answers. But when it came to topics like yesterday's routine or any other topic for that matter, speaking, so I also made them write, because our main objective was to improve their writing skills. And they would send their assignments on my personal window or email me also at times. Then I would correct it and send them back.
Okay, so overall, Kiran Balwani, what do you have to say as you have upgraded yourself to an online corporate trainer? So what do you have to say about yourself, the upgradation in your skills and the experience that you're with?
So definitely, I would say that I have been working with BM for more than a decade now. But so far, somewhere, I think in between doing the same thing again and again, the excitement or the thrill had died down. So I would say that is back. I feel really excited. I was excited from day one, and a very thrilling experience. Very different. So we trainers keep needing such changes from time to time. Trying out. And I think everybody should give it a try.
Yeah, and I think one day you said I said, you know, are you starting your online training today? You said, yeah, my flight is waiting, and I'm boarding the flight. So what was that?
Yes, sir, because it gives you that feeling, like when you are here in front of the camera on Zoom and you control 15 learners, 20 learners, you can control even more than that, in fact. So the control is in your hands. Like, you click a button and you can mute them. You can unmute them. So I literally got a feeling that I was the pilot running the craft. And today, okay, I think I have landed successfully.
Wonderful.
This is the takeoff and this is the landing.
Yeah, I also heard the same clapping sound that Dhawal has taught you. That clapping, yes, throughout the session, right? I used to sometimes enter into your training room online.
Correct, sir. And it's really amazing. I mean, technology has advanced so much that, sir, you at Kandivali or anywhere would enter, you know, you would join our meetings and give us a surprise. And similarly, I mean, if I wanted, I could also stop the video and just silently I would watch what the class is doing. I did that, of course, for very brief moments. not all the time, but then really this is the magic, I would say.
Good, excellent. Kiran, Vignesh is extremely happy. I just met him a couple of days back. He's extremely happy with the results that you have produced, and he's looking forward for more. And I wish the corporate sales department, Maya and Ritu, come up with more online training orders very soon.
And I'm really thankful to them for recommending my name. Ritu always comes up with a lot of opportunities for me. Thank you, sir. And it was possible only because of you, because one thing, and I gave my 100% to this, sir, because your one statement really touched. It was really touching when you said, Kiran, I cannot give up on you. So thank you, sir. Thank you.
Good. And you continued and you did it. Okay, good. So all the best.
Thank you.
And good. Looking forward to more assignments like this.
Yes, sir.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye, sir. Thank you.